The bark may be out of Vic's defense. Hey, how are you, folks? Jason Horwitz with you on the Sports Update. The Falcons quarterback was set to stand trial beginning November 26th, facing felony charges stemming from his alleged involvement in dogfighting. It may not last longer than this week. Vic, the last man still standing, at least to this point, pleading not guilty. Two of his fellow co-defendants, Pernell Peace and Quanis Phillips, Monday both agreed to appear in court later this week and accept plea agreements. The fourth defendant, Tony Taylor, has already done so, meaning all three would be cleared to testify against Vic. Now, sources saying his attorneys met with federal prosecutor Michael Gill Monday afternoon and that Vic is weighing his options. Those reports also saying the quarterback has until Friday to decide whether or not to accept a plea agreement. The Pac-Man Jones saga continues as well. Aside from his thoughts on TNA wrestling, this involves his legal issues. In a story airing on Tuesday night's edition of HBO's Real Sports with Bryant Gumbel, Jones says he sees himself as an innocent bystander in the Las Vegas strip club fight that led to a triple shooting. In the piece, Jones says, quote, "I never touched anybody in that. I never hit no girl. I never told anyone of them that I was going to kill them." Much more on the story can be seen as the cornerback continues to serve his one-year suspension from the NFL following, among numerous arrests, his indictment on two counts of coercion. Other NFL notes on the field, well, sort of. Thomas Jones' agent, Drew Rosenhaus, always good for a conversation, has said that his client has a strained right calf muscle and is, quote, confident he'll be back by the open of the season. Chiefs running back Larry Johnson still yet to find his way to camp, but his holdout could soon be over. Kansas City Star reporting that Johnson and the Chiefs have narrowed the monetary gap in contract talks to the point where the Pro Bowl running back could be in camp as early as this week. And Raiders rookie head coach Lane Kiffin Monday entered a hospital with a viral infection and may not return to the team till the end of this week. Hospital staff would not delve information, but coordinators Greg Knapp and Rob Ryan will run the team in his absence. Placido Polanco is one of those quiet guys you don't really think of on a regular basis. Never a superstar, but his .344 batting average, third in the AL, behind teammate Magleor Ordóñez and Ichiro. Yet Monday, it was his defense in need of discussion. Polanco setting a major league record, now with 144 consecutive games without an error. The longest in Major League Baseball history for a second baseman. The longest for any infielder is 193 set by Steve Garvey. Tigers did lose to the A's 7-2, though, setting up a short two-game set in Cleveland with the two teams tied atop the AL Central. Just three games Tuesday with both teams owning winning records. Tigers and Indians won, the other two between the Angels and Blue Jays, as well as the Rockies and Padres. All right, time for the Wits hits. Barry Bonds saying Monday he doesn't think he'll play after 2008. When asked if he's waiting for 3,000 hits, he said it'd be nice to finish with a championship and 3,000 hits, currently 81 away from that mark. White Sox pitcher Jose Contreras Monday cleared waivers and became eligible to be traded to any interested team. He is, though, 6-14. The righty owed $22 million by the end of 2009. And Arkansas wide receiver Marcus Monk will miss 4 to 6 weeks with a knee injury. The 6'6" Monk grabbed 11 touchdown receptions last season for the Razorbacks, setting a school record. All right, so that'll do it for the Sports Update presented by Toyota for Tuesday, August 14th. Enjoy a great night in sports. I'm Jason Horwitz. Take care.